There were a lot of questions that arose when Todd Phillips was announced as the director for a standalone hard R-rated Joker film. Many were uncertain of the implications, but my initial reaction was, the guy whose line from Old School was,
"I'm here for the gangbang."
That's the guy who's going to be directing Joker? Okay, Warner Brothers, all right. But lo and behold, we are here. So let's get ready to talk Joker now.
Did you rub my lamp?
Thousand generations to the Nina.
Here we go.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? And welcome to FilmSpeak, where film is our second language. I'm Griffin, as always, and if film is your second language, consider hitting that subscribe button for more insightful and articulate film discourse and analysis. Joker is directed by Todd Phillips, and it stars Joaquin Phoenix, Zazie Beetz, and Robert De Niro. The film follows Arthur Fleck, a failed stand-up comedian and sales clown who's been abused, beaten down both physically and mentally, and discarded by society. Consumed by negative thoughts and a warped sense of self-righteousness, Fleck begins a slow descent into madness as he transforms into the infamous Joker. As I alluded to in the opening, Todd Phillips is a rather odd choice to usher in an era of auteur-driven comic book films, yet with Joker, he emerges as an unlikely hero. Joker utilizes the popularity of the comic book movie platform to bring audiences a new character story. In a repulsive, vile, and evil exploration of one of comics' most iconic villains, Phillips changes the lens through which we view movies in this genre. There's much to process in Phillips' 70s-inspired mood piece. It's a story that, given the socio-political landscape of our country, needed the absolute perfect touch in order to thread the needle properly on a potentially astute commentary on the status of our society. Believe me, I can already sense the "we live in a society" memes incoming, but the fact of the matter is, Joker very much holds a mirror up to the tightly wound and problematic nature of the times we currently live in. It unflinchingly questions our methods of supposedly preventing a mass murderer such as Arthur Fleck from reaching the point of no return, expounding upon the environment that fosters such deeply horrific psychological distress. Phillips implies that if nothing changes, then this already scarily real comic book fantasy may be in the cards for our future. However, the onus is not placed solely on society, as sometimes these demons manifest themselves through uncontrolled circumstances, as the seemingly ordinary can trigger impulses of unfathomable consequences. In the end, these inhuman individuals must be held accountable for their actions. Much of the pre-screening talk surrounding Joker was cautious of Phillips' portrayal of the clown prince of crime. Would he condemn or condone the character's incel behavior? While others' interpretations may vary, for me, Phillips made it abundantly clear that Arthur is 100% the villain. We as an audience should be disturbed and off-put by his vile actions. He kills for pleasure and without remorse. He incites victimhood as justification for his actions, joking, "What do you get when you cross a mentally ill loner with a society that treats him like trash?" Yeah, wait for the punchline on that one. Phillips conveys a cautionary tale of what happens when you give such a deranged and unstable individual a platform, showcasing the destruction and chaos that follows suit. He even retorts many of Arthur's warped claims of self-pity through Robert De Niro's Murray Franklin in the film's climactic confrontation. While Phillips' ambition provides meaty material, the success of Joker truly rests on the shoulders of Joaquin Phoenix. Commanding the screen in every single scene, it's not hyperbole to say that Phoenix's portrayal of the Joker may be some of the actor's most exceptional work to date. All restraints are lifted as he sinks to the darkest recesses of his psyche to inhabit such a troubled and volatile individual. There's a vulnerability to Phoenix as an actor that perfectly lends itself to Arthur's insecurities as he projects them onto the world around him through a gradual transformation into the infamous clown. Through every awkward encounter, erratic tic, forced smile, troubled confession, and emotionless kill, Phoenix disturbingly shifts through every phase of Arthur's descent into madness. His sporadic and uncontrolled laughter, the result of a medical condition, is painful, inhuman, and devoid of all genuine emotion. It's the sound of someone so desperately unsure of how to be a real person. It's only when Arthur fully gives in to the darkness within him that he truly feels alive. As a result, Phoenix is at his most eccentric and colorful when he's hiding behind a red suit and layers of makeup in what is one of the scariest interpretations of the Joker ever put to screen. Taking heavily from mid-70s and early 80s grunge films, Joker unabashedly wears its influences of Taxi Driver and The King of Comedy on its sleeve. The streets of Gotham are littered in graffiti, grit, and grime. Lawrence Sher's dimly lit and rustic cinematography utilizes sickly yellow and greens to match the uneasiness invoked by our main character. Hildur Guðnadóttir's haunting and eerie score envelops audiences in darkness, texturizing the unsettling pieces already in play. Before I give you my final verdict on Joker, guys, why don't you take a second here and like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to this channel for more insightful and articulate film discourse and analysis. Todd Phillips's isolated character study is one that's sure to elicit many contrasting reactions, but there's no denying the level of craftsmanship on display here. It's a gross, provocative, bleak experience that leaves one hopeless and numb, causing us to reflect on our own society. Joker isn't a film that reinvents the wheel. Its lead performance elevates a pretty standard script. However, it does usher in a new era of what exactly a comic book film can be, and so perhaps its greatest gift is the arts that it will inspire. And so, for all of these reasons and the reasons I've mentioned throughout my review, I'm ultimately going to be giving Joker an 8.7 out of 10. And now I want to hear from you all. I want to know what the next comic book character study film you want to see is. I'm talking about movies that focus solely on a hero or a villain and gives us a deep dive into their psyche, just like Joker. I'll tell you the one I'm looking forward to most, Freeze, based off of Heart of Ice from Batman the Animated Series. I want to see that. I guarantee you they'll probably do it somewhere along the road. As always, guys, you can like FilmSpeak on Facebook by searching FilmSpeak Official and follow us on Twitter simply by searching _FilmSpeak. And lastly, if you like me specifically and you like what I have to say, you can give me a follow on Twitter @GriffSchiller. All right, that's going to do it for this review, guys, and I'll catch you next time. Take care.